science explorers, it's Justin again. And Mia and I are in the last biome of our life science adventure, the tropical rainforest. This place is full of life. Plants, animals, and insects are everywhere you look. How is it possible so much life is sustained here? Well, today we'll explore the rainforest from top to bottom and uncover just how this biome is able to house so much life. Let's get into it. A rainforest is a biome that's made up of lots of tall trees and has a high amount of rainfall. Rainforests can receive up to 400 inches of rain in a year. Because of all this moisture, it's really humid here. The air feels wet, and it's hot too. Why do you think that is? Tropical rainforests are located in many different parts of the world, but I think I see a pattern here. These are all very close to the equator. That explains the heat. Rainforests typically contain a large source of fresh water. The Amazon rainforest in South America, for example, grows along the Amazon River, one of the longest rivers on Earth. The warm air absorbs the moisture from the rivers, then dumps it back onto the Earth when it rains. This cycle repeats over and over, keeping the rainforests, well, rainy. These wet and warm conditions are exactly what plants need to thrive. And since rainforests are located along the equator, these biomes don't experience four distinct seasons. It's always warm and wet here, so plants rarely have a reason to go dormant. They can continue to grow and produce flowers and fruit all year round. With plenty of fresh water and food and shelter in the trees, the rainforest sounds like a pretty great place for many living things to call home. Just like we saw in the coral reefs in the ocean, the rainforest is a host to a vast amount of biodiversity, or the variety of life you can find in one area. As a matter of fact, around 50% or half of the planet's plant, insect, and animal species live in the rainforest. Wow. With so many animals living here, how is there space for all of them? Of course, these biomes certainly don't take up half of the globe's space, so many rainforest residents find their homes up in the trees. Kind of like living in a high-rise apartment building. We can break down some of those vertical habitats into four layers. Right now, we're on the forest floor. The bottom layer. It's really dark down here. How do the plants even grow with such little sunlight? You know, I'd like to start exploring from the tops of the trees and then work our way down. I wonder how I can get a good look up there. I've got it. Woo-hoo! Wow, it's much brighter up here. In the rainforest, this is called the emergent layer, where the tops of the trees reach the sunlight. This is where the tree leaves can best absorb energy from the sun, enough to power all of this immense tree growth. Ooh, look, it's a fruit bat. These flying mammals feed on flower nectar and help pollinate the trees here. Hummingbirds and butterflies help pollinate the plants up here too. Moving down, now we're in the canopy. This is where most of the plants and animals are. The forest here is very dense with branches and leaves, giving climbing and flying animals lots of places to find food and shelter. Check out these spider monkeys. Looks like they're eating some of the fruit from these trees. When they're finished, they'll disperse the seeds back to the ground and eventually they'll sprout a brand new plant. You'll also spot parrots, toucans, sloths, and other flying or climbing animals in the canopy. These consumers are kind of like the rainforest's gardeners, maintaining the life cycle of the plants here. Further down, we reach the rainforest's understory layer. Here, we'll find a lot of the shorter plants like palms and flower bushes, and some of the larger animals that can move between the trees and the ground to find food. Oh, can you see that? It's a python, one of the rainforest's largest reptiles. With their strong bodies and clever camouflage, they can sneak up on smaller animals in the trees. Hey, is that a leopard? Didn't we see these big cats in the savannah? Oh, right. I can tell by its spots that this is actually a jaguar. Another one of the rainforest's consumers, they help keep the bustling animal population here under control by hunting in the trees, as well as in the rivers and ponds. And with that, we are back on the forest floor. You won't find as many plants and animals here because of how dark it is, but we can find some of the living things that don't rely on light so much. Our decomposers. Fungi, beetles, and worms eat away at dead plants and process them back into the soil. They make the soil rich and healthy, creating the perfect conditions for new plants to take root. From the enormous trees, to the birds on the branches, to the tiny worms in the soil, every part of the rainforest plays an important role in maintaining this biome. Mia says all of this biodiversity isn't just important for the rainforest. The rainforest helps the rest of the planet too? What do you think? How can all the variety of plants and animals here help the rest of the planet? Write down your ideas in your field notes, and then we can dig a little deeper. Oh, remember how plants give off oxygen during photosynthesis? With the dense network of trees and other plants here, rainforests create a ton of oxygen that helps keep our air clean and healthy to breathe. And with all of this healthy growth comes a lot of natural products we use every day. Wood, fruits like bananas and avocados, and ingredients like vanilla and cocoa all come from rainforest plants. It sounds like the tropical rainforest is an essential part of our Earth. It's home to so much life and produces so many important things that sustain life all over the world. Whoa, Mia, can you zoom in on this? It looks like a stick, but I think it's alive? We definitely have to take a closer look at that next time. Thanks for joining us today. And remember, our wildest discoveries are yet to come. Until our next journey, science explorers! Hey!